First, though, all eyes are again on Christchurch this week.
Today's news of around 5,000 homes being abandoned in Bexley, Avonside, Avondale, Burwood, Horseshoe Lake and Dellington finished a week of uncertainty.
John Utanga met up with Pacific people in those eastern suburbs earlier this week.
The front yard's actually quite good. It's all the footpaths and that, John, as you can see here.
Inspecting the damage caused by yet more aftershocks.
You said there were some big holes opened up actually on the footpath?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Not just on the footpaths on this street, John. We've had probably three or four trucks stuck, or cars stuck in holes, in different holes down here.
Parklands in the east is home for Cook Islander Kiria Metuatini. It's one of the areas worst hit by flooding and liquefaction when the two big aftershocks struck last week.
I think we're a bit, shocked that it even happened again, really, I suppose. Mum's pretty strong. Yeah, the wife's pretty strong.
But the disruptions worry Kiria, whose elderly mother recently returned from Auckland.
My mum's sick. I wish she wasn't here, John, and that's the honest fact of it. She needs a nebuliser, you know. Like last night, our power cuts out. I worried that my mum had none, you know. And when I went there for my safety, I was just glad that she had power and she was on her nebuliser. She would have needed it, you know.
And more worry, Kiria's 13-year-old daughter Tessa, here waiting with friends to catch the bus across town to start school in Burnside at 1 p.m. This means she gets home at about 6 at night.
Well, I worry, you know, it's dark out there. I worry what she's up to, if she's walking home safely in the muck that she's got to walk through and all that.
Now that it's winter and it's pretty dark, so it's kind of freaky walking home. I just want it to be like back to how it was before, like not having to travel so far and being able to go places without the shakes and stuff.
The Metuatinis are like many Pacific families in Christchurch, making ends meet as best they can. For those struggling to cope, help is at hand right here at the Pacific Hub in Aranui. Now, it was supposed to close in April, but as we found out, it's still open for the community.
With government services fragmented, the hub plays a vital role in getting Pacific people urgent help. Since wage subsidies ended nearly 6 weeks ago, job losses have climbed.
A lot of our people are being made redundant because they work in the service industries, and of course that's not functioning all that well at the moment. It doesn't help when you're young and got children and you're struggling to keep your head above water as it is with currently what's going on. And
across town in Shirley, Pacific Trust Canterbury has a new health clinic. Their old premises is in the CBD red zone. For the last 8 weeks, they've run an outreach service trying to gauge the needs of the community.
Lots of our families that we know, especially through our clinic, have transferred out of Christchurch, and we know this, that predominantly Auckland. We do have, there's been quite a big movement, probably on the western side, where a lot of our families have had families on the west side.
But those families that have stayed are heading back to their homes. New manager Tony Whakaho says after last week, they'll need help.
With the last quake, you know, it's going to cause more trauma, and you know, we've got a strong team of mental health workers that we can also help the communities.
Meanwhile, last week's big aftershocks just continues to frustrate.
All the rest of the dramas that a lot of people in Christchurch are going through, over it, way over it. But we are lucky. We got power back on later that night, and we had water back on and sewer within by the end of the week.
For homeowner Kiria Metuatini, who lost his job soon after the February quake, survival's the name of the game. His wife and an older daughter work to pay the bills.
Is the plan to try and find work here or anywhere?
I don't have a plan, John. It's just to survive right now and get me to a point where I know what's going to happen with my house and then, you know, I can move on from there. I don't look too far forward.
And you're making those mortgage payments and all that?
Just, John, just.
For now, the Metuatinis are tied to Christchurch, but who knows what the future holds.